हेलो, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू वर्किंग ऑफ थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर. ओके, सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर, देर इज़ अ स्पेशल थिंग इन इट, दैट इज़ इट डज नॉट हैव एनी रियल मैग्नेटिक पोल्स. ओके, इट डज नॉट हैव एनी रियल मैग्नेटिक पोल्स, आई मीन वी आर नॉट यूजिंग द मैग्नेट्स. बट वेन वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग सम कैलकुलेशंस लाइक स्लिप एंड अदर कैलकुलेशंस, बट वी डू कंसिडर द मैग्नेटिक पोल्स. So those are assumed magnetic poles. Okay, so as already we have seen, so there are three main points we have noticing this, that three phase induction motor does not have any magnets, real magnets, or these are all assumed magnets. So that is the first point, no poles. And the second point is that it is having only the assumed poles. And the third point is that it is having three phases, and every phase between the angle difference it is 120 degree, then only it is called balanced system. Suppose sometime if any system get problem, like suppose any fault occurs, then this will not maintain 120 degree. So the three phase, all the three phases becomes the one, it will not maintain 120 degree, it will have some other different angle, then the system becomes unbalanced system. Under unbalanced system, heavy current will flow. Like for example, in case, let us assume we have three phase system like this. Okay, now here 120 degree, here 120 degree, and here 120 degree. Suppose this phase get problem, and let's say it has become open circuit. So now what will happen? Now the whole angle become 240 degree. Okay, so when it is 240 degree and there are a lot of technical issues will happen, then the system becomes the faulty system. This needs to be rectified. Okay, so now how does the this induction motor will work? Okay, simple, very simple. Here we have a stator. Okay, now this here we have rotor. This stator we give supply, that is we give three phase supply, and this stator has a three phase winding. When the supply is given, this three phase winding will produce three phase flux. Okay, this three phase flux look like this. Because it is having 120 degree angle difference, so one can be R phase, Y phase, B phase. Okay, actually here it is given R phase, R it is, it should be phase B. So it is rotating at every voltage, because in all over the world we use 50 hertz frequency. So what do you mean by 50 hertz frequency? If it is AC, means what is AC? Suppose if this is the voltage, this the maximum voltage is, let's say, 250 volt. So this voltage will have oscillate like this. This is 250. Between 250, it oscillates like this. It keeps on oscillating like this. So how fast it is oscillating? It is per second 50 times it oscillates, then it is a 50 hertz frequency. If it is oscillating for 20 times, then it is 20 hertz frequency. If it is likewise, okay, so here we are capturing some moment, but actually there won't be any gap, it will be like this, there won't be any gap. Okay, because it at per second 50 times. So in this is how the flux will be produced. Okay, the flux is produced here. It is producing three phase flux. Now this three phase flux, the flux produced by this stator, we call it as rotating magnetic field. This is very important, you should know. Rotating magnetic field. What do you mean by rotating magnetic field? Means the flux does not be stationary. It keeps rotating like this. The flux start rotating like this. Okay, it keeps rotating. Now this we have a rotor, and rotor is now standstill. When you give the supply, before giving the supply, the rotor will not rotate. So once you give the supply, what happens? The windings in the induction motor produce the rotating magnetic field, that is flux, and that is rotating. Okay, So whatever the points I'm saying, this rotating magnetic field means, we will see separately how do we get the rotating magnetic field separately. Each and every notations what I use, I will be explaining one by one. Okay, now once if a rotor is stationary, if something is rotating like this, what will happen? See here. Now this rotating magnetic field cuts the rotor. Okay, this magnetic field cuts the rotor. Now what do you mean by rotor? Rotor is also like a stator only. We'll be having windings. This rotor is also consist of winding, closed loop. Okay, now when the flux cuts this rotor, what will happen? The EMF will be induced. What do you mean by EMF? EMF is the voltage. Okay, due to induction principle, EMF will be induced in the rotor as well. Now in this rotor, whatever the EMF is induced, due to that current will flow, and that current will produce the flux in the rotor as well. Okay, now with a single supply we have two magnetic fields. One is produced by the stator and another one is produced by the rotor. Okay, so there will be interaction between this stator magnetic field, the stator magnetic field as well as the rotor magnetic field. Okay, so these interactions produce the torque. Some force will be produced and that torque makes the rotor to rotate. Okay, now what is a new term we saw? Rotating magnetic field. That is a separate topic. And one more point is that when we say this rotating magnetic field is rotating, so there is one point is there, at what speed it rotates. Okay, so when we have a stator, when we having the stator, when the stator windings produce the flux, when we say that flux, this flux is rotating, so this flux rotates at a speed of synchronous speed. Synchronous speed. So we will separately detail, we'll be seeing what do you mean by synchronous speed, how to determine it. Generally the synchronous speed formula is, that is ns. N means speed, always universally speed we say in the by using capital N. S is for the synchronous speed, and synchronous speed is equal to 120 f by p. So what do you mean by p? Number of poles. As already told you, the induction motor does not have a number of poles, but still we consider number of poles by assuming according to the flux value. Now this is the frequency. Frequency means the supply. The what is the supply of frequency we are providing? That is 120 f by p. So in case, if this is in induction motor, if in case it has a four magnetic poles, that is here it is four, and then it, if we are giving 50 hertz frequency, then n is equal to, you will get 1500 rpm, that is rotating per minute, 1500 rpm. The flux produced in the stator will be rotating at this particular speed. Okay, so this is how the three phase induction motor rotates, operates. Now one more point is that this three phase induction motor, there is another name for this. This is called asynchronous. Okay, what do you mean by asynchronous? Means this induction motor rotor will not rotate at synchronous speed. It is always asynchronous speed. Okay, and we have always synchronous machines also. This induction motor comes under the asynchronous. Now we all understood that here generally what students will do this mistake here is, they assume that, they think that the stator is also rotating. The stator does not rotate. Try to understand, the stator is the outer body. If stator rotates, if you keep your induction motor at one place, once you switch on it, and the induction motor will start rolling and go somewhere. The stator is not rotating, only the rotor is rotating, but the magnetic field produced by the stator is rotating. Okay, so that magnetic field, it is rotating at the speed of synchronous speed, that is ns. Okay, now whatever the action is taking place, already we see how this happens. This stator magnetic field rotates, and here we have the rotor, it cuts the rotor, and EMF is induced, current is produced, flux is produced, and due to the interaction between those two fluxes, stator magnetic field and rotor magnetic field, torque is produced, and that torque rotates this rotor. Now the rotor is also start rotate. So this one we can say rotor speed nr. Ns is the synchronous speed, not stator speed, and nr is the rotor speed. Now what will happen is this rotor also will rotate in the same direction. Like magnetic field rotating in clockwise means the rotor is also rotating in the same direction. When this is rotating in the same direction, this rotor nr try to catch the synchronous speed ns, try to catch, always there is a competition, but it never catches. That is the nr never be equal to ns. Nr is always less. That is why asynchronous, because it does not able to rotate at synchronous speed. Okay, so always there is a speed difference. This speed difference only we define as term called slip. So this is very important. By using this we will get lot of numericals to solve, and it will be very very useful to understand remaining part of the induction motor. Okay, so the new term, now we are understanding the third point is rotating, first point rotating magnetic field, second one is the how do we get the synchronous speed, and third one is the slip. Okay, now there is a formula used for the slip, percentage slip. So the percentage slip is equal to ns minus nr, that is synchronous speed minus the rotor speed, divided by the synchronous speed multiplied by 100. Okay, multiplied by 100. So this is a percentage. And now when we suppose if you want to, not in percentage, simply the slip value, if you calculate, then it becomes ns minus nr by ns, which is equal to 1 minus nr by ns. Okay, then that is s equal to, or now you can keep minus nr by ns is equal to s minus 1. Okay, now so I am writing in very big letters, let me write. So s minus 1, s minus 1 equal to 1 minus nr by ns. So it can be written nr by ns is equal to 1 minus s. So nr can be written as ns into 1 minus s. Okay, so this is a new formula. Like from, by using the slip value and by using the synchronous speed, we can find out the rotor speed, at what speed the rotor may rotate. Okay, so there are some other calculations also will be coming. So this is a complete induction motor working. Now I have to explain you what is synchronous speed, how do we get the formula, that is 120 f by p, how do we get this value. And completely to understand how the rotating magnetic field is produced, that's it, and the slip also you have understand. Okay, so thank you. I hope you understand this three phase induction motor working principle, and let us meet in next lecture. Thank you.